Hello, hello. Hi, everybody. Let me say hi. Trickle Tom, yay first. Ivermectin, I better get to Bangkok before the world ends. My feet are tired. Hypatia, you did make it. Thank you for being here. Hey, El Deuterino, I hope you're having a good day too. And let's see. Hey, Jay Snyder. Hi, Tiffany. Love you too. And hi, Tawny. And hello, Mr. Crow. Okay, so, caca. Hi, Audra P. Hello, good morning and good afternoon. And hello, Add-on. Thank you so much for being here. So, hi, Anna, the inbred Nazi. Hey, Echo Cat. What's up, man? I'm so glad that you're here. Hi, Annie Kurtz. Hello. All right. Oh, thank you, Ann Audra. I appreciate you. Okay, guys. So, I found so much good stuff in the newspaper archive. Seriously, it's a gold mine. It's a gold mine because I've been going back through and cleaning up the PowerPoint. And when I notice like a little difference, even in spelling or them saying like the foundation Church of God versus the foundation Faith of God or the foundation Church of the Millennium, I've literally found Christopher DePeyer in a newspaper in Utah. And I also found Christopher Fripp, John Fripp. Like, it's amazing. I'm so glad I finally have it. And I have more pictures. Hi, Coop Films. So we're going to run the intro and then I want to show you guys because, you know, they're doing all this weird, you know, laying of hands and stuff, but they are also absolutely calling for the end of the world. You know what I mean? There's no difference in their theology. And I think the earliest that I've tracked this to is 1971, which is, you know, right after what happened in California. So let's go.
What is the process?
Must we drag all that up again?
Is it all to the death? Better hold your breath. In the cell, I prevail. Freddy sent from hell. Ring the bell when you're finished. I'm a grown man and winning. Sacrifice it to the demons. No, I love it when you screaming. Commit to your thoughts. Do it now while you lost in the darkness. You will never wake up so conscious, anxious. Why are you so scared of feeling pain, bitch? Devil in your soul. Cut it now and then you'll go. Walk on the dark path. Kill and you feel that. Never in your life you gotta rush from the kickback. Matt Black, Glock 10, knock on the neck, man. Hear the whispering, devil taking over them. Listen to my words, the Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words, the Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. All red on me, got the blood up in your hair. Sign your soul to the devil, now you asking is it fair? Listen to my words, the Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words, the Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. All red on me, got the blood up in your hair. Sign your soul to the devil, now you asking is it fair?
Listen to my words, the Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words, the Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words, the Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words, the Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words, the Freddy, tell it do the devil's work. Listen to my words, the Freddy, tell it do the devil's work.
Don't forget, we are literally out here fighting demons, y'all. And hello, Don Lambert. Thank you so much for being here. Hi, David Tooley. Hello, hello. Hi, everybody. All right. What did you say about the Pentecostals? There's a lot of the, like I said, I'm going to show you guys not everything that I found because we would be here all day and you guys have better things to do, but I want to show you some things. Now, you do need a purple cape. I agree. Man, these damn intel agencies, the feds, like to use multiple names and also misspellings to hide their crap in plain sight. Usually FOIA will get you little to nothing because they'll misspell a name. That's exactly right, El Deuterino. Like, the FBI file and the FOIA file, like, it shows that they were ordered to, like, hide things, to retract things. You know what I mean? So, it's, yeah, they're doing it on purpose. That's all that they're doing. I want to show you guys first because, remember, I had you guys, like, take a vote, Sister Sharon St. Joan, Mother Sharon St. Joan. I think I was wrong because now that I have found more, I found a photo that was taken by Janet Beyer, supposedly, of Sharon St. Joan. And this photo of Sharon St. Joan, she's much older, like much older at the time. So I think that I was definitely wrong, but I want to show you guys what I found. That way, you know, I'm not a liar. But I also did find her high school photo. I found a yearbook photo, which, you know, I love these old pictures. You guys know that I do. So I thought that that was very exciting. So obviously her slide is not as pretty as it once was. And I'm probably going to, you know, drag it over to the next slide. But let's go ahead and show you guys this, because now I have to figure out who Janet Beyer is, because I was wrong. You know what I mean? Okay, so this is her. Remember, I had you guys take a vote where we're like, it's different angles, right? So this photo right here, so she's a bird lady. This lady scares me. She's a straight up thug with these birds, dude. But you see, that doesn't look like Janet Beyer to me. Now the photo right here next to her, that's a new photo that I found. Yeah. So it still looks like Janet Beyer, but look at this. So the controversy of faith healing is explored with nationally known faith healer, Sharon St. Joan. So she was known, when I tell you guys, they were all over TV, they were all over the radio, and that's her. So her real name is Gretchen Lawrence. I did find her. That is from 1961 at Aiken High School, I believe. Which, I mean, I'm glad that I found her, because I found one newspaper that sort of gave their information, yeah? But I just thought that that was so fascinating. So I don't think that that is, Janet Beyer. And there she is. I believe that this is in New York at the Foundation Faith of God. And she is laying the healing hands, yeah? So that's her. I was wrong, but that's okay, because now I just have another person that I have to find, which is quite unfortunate, but it is what it is. Let me see. And they use names that mean the same thing. The feds use a synonym finder more than Slayer writing lyrics. Yeah, seriously. I'm being more diligent about reading through like the newspapers, like when they're doing their interviews. I mean, now that I'm going back through, because that's where I'm finding a lot of the fruit stuff. It's okay, Meatball. I appreciate you and I understand. I hardly watch videos anymore, but I do watch The Dana Show. Thank you so much, Don Lambert. If peak spiciness is 10, are you at an 11? You guys are so silly. All right, now let me see who. Oh, so the other chick, I identified her as well. And It's obviously her. Like, there's no question. And her slide isn't perfect, but man, I was super stoked to find her. And she has a really beautiful photo from her wedding in here, which I think is really nice. But yeah, this is her. She's also laying the hands. You know what I mean? Okay. So on the far right, down here, Sister Hava. Couldn't find her, but I did. I found her. Yeah. So there she is when she got married. And that is her yearbook photo from 1963. And right there, Blair Lawrence talks about another approach to healing. Yeah, and there she is with Sharon St. Jones in Indianapolis. Now, I did really find her yearbook little blurb here very interesting, so I threw it in here. Class votes her the biggest hobo, usually found at home where the boys are, would die if she stopped trying to be different. Most remembered for being tardy. Favorite saying, does anybody have any gum? She'd like to forget certain AA dances. We'd like to forget her clothes. Greatest fear, she will someday misspell Lance's name. Secret ambition, to go steady with Dee Dee. Ooh, I wonder what that means. Pet peeve, spelling. Like to be one of the herd. We will never understand her. Her prized possession, her controlling interest in Bazooka Bubblegum Company. So weird, right? It's just so bizarre. But like when you compare these photos, yeah, that's definitely her. But I think that, like, they were really not nice to her. I'm like, dang, why'd you guys put that in there? But who knows? I mean, maybe she was not a nice person. Hi, Lufus Glymate. I'm so glad that you're here. Hey, Mad Villain, what's up? Let me see. I always give a false name when speaking with reporters. I mean, I just don't think that they even asked them. I really don't. Which, it's like, okay, you know, the stuff that was going on, especially when we're coming around to, like, the time of Jonestown, it's like, don't you think that it would be astute to kind of clarify for people, since people are concerned about cults specifically? You know what I mean? I mean, that's just my two cents. What do I know? Now, I want to show you another person, because now that I've got the picture of Timothy Wiley's wife, I can show you guys Brother Reuben. Let me see. Bazooka Joe Bubblegum is nasty. They thought that they were clever. Yeah, they think they're clever, but they're not. They also think that they're smart, and they're not, because I'm figuring them out. So here we go. All right, so this is one of the most well-known photos. So that's Brother Reuben and Mother Maya. So Mother Maya on the left specifically, that's Timothy Wiley's wife, which is weird. And she was a prophetess. Yeah, kind of weird. But that's in Cambridge. And there he is, Father Reuben, young and committed. New religious group gives Satan his due. Okay. And right, see, they spell it Margaret Drayton Wiley, but they spell the last name wrong, which is really weird. But Timothy Wiley even talks about being married in Love, Sex, Fear, and Death. So, I mean, that's her. And then Father Reuben is Arthur Mendelssohn. And over here, obviously, I had to find, I mean, you can't really see him in that photo. But I did find him in a newspaper, and there is his yearbook, but that's him speaking out on world affairs, yeah? And there he is right there, before the devil got him. And here he's just talking about, specifically in Chicago, whatever, the state of the world, and we're giving out food for Thanksgiving, whatever. Anyways, that way you guys have now seen Timothy Wiley's wife. I really have had a hard time finding anything about her. And the way that he speaks about her specifically in Love, Sex, Fear, and Death is, I won't say it's suspicious, but it's very weird. He makes it seem like Mary Ann was forcing them to do X, Y, and Z. Obviously, I can't confirm or deny. I have no idea. But as you guys are well aware of now, I do not trust these people, not one bit. Now, let me see who I want to go to next. Oh, I want to show you guys that Savundra was involved in specifically the Perfumo affair. Yeah, because I said that he was, but I need to show you guys. And we're not really going to get into it, honestly, anytime soon, because this guy, you're going to see, he was quite a playboy. Yeah. And a woman wrote a book about him, apparently. Hi, Leash 23. Hello. Mother Maya needs to stop IFing in the photo. Got that serial stare. Yeah, no, she straight up looks like a sociopath in that picture. All right. And let me see. They all have the Manson crazy eyes. Oh, thank you so much, Leash 23. I appreciate it very much. Yeah, they do all have the Manson crazy eyes. I think they're just trying to come off as edgy, quite frankly. I don't take them seriously, like, at all. I think that these people are trying to be edgy, you know, like, because then they literally turn around and they're like, we're doing Jesus rock. We're Jesus freaks, right? And then they play the victim. So it's like, yeah, they have the sociopath stare, but I think that they're faking it because they are shapeshifters. So I added some stuff here. And there he is. That is him and his old lady. Very, very bad boy. And this gal, her mom was quite proud that she was involved in the Perfumo affair. Mandy is sparing the blushes, yeah? But she implicates Dr. Emil Savundra and Lord Dudley, amongst others. But this next slide is going to be much more entertaining. He got a death threat. This dude was getting in a lot of trouble. Let me see if I can just pop over here. There we go. Look at this dude. He is straight. Oh, no. Go back. Stop it. Okay, there we go. Look at him. Yeah? Ah, oh, dang it. This thing is... There we go. The game is up, Dr. Savundra. Literally, when I look at this picture, all I hear is Big Pimpin' by Jay-Z. Like, that's what I hear in my head, and I just imagine that this dude is, like, straight up vibing out, because this dude was involved in so many scandals. And apparently, it was what was considered in the UK the first trial by television, where he got grilled about everything. So I thought that this was really fascinating, and obviously someday we will do a very deep dive on The Good Doctor, because I think that this is a perfect sort of vehicle for money laundering specifically. Because like I said, I can only find Doubly's Limited. I can't find anything else as far as our MS and MA de Grimston Limited, but we know that it existed, right? And they obviously had to have money before that. You know what I mean? Didn't just pop up out of nowhere. Now, I'm going to show you guys. Let me zoom out of this, because now we're just going to look, and this is not a specific timeline, but I'm going to show you guys how full of crap these people are. Yeah? Because they are full of crap. And I want first, I'm going to show you one, because this guy looks so familiar to me. Like, but I don't know who he looks like. But he looks like, I'm assuming, someone famous. But as soon as I saw him, I was like, who is that? Because he sticks out to me like a sore thumb. And I've never seen him before. Ever. Never seen him before. So let me start with this one. Because I don't know who this dude is. But maybe one of you guys will. Because he has a very, like, striking appearance, in my opinion. Let me see what you guys said. Lord Dudley, I've ran into him about that one British Prime Minister, Heath, Edward Heath. Let me see. And Heath is right there with Savile. Oh, well, that's lovely. That's fantastic. Yeah, let's get Savile back into the picture here, because literally The Process interviewed Savile, like, one of their first publications. It was Jonathan Depierre who ended up marrying Marianne. You know what I mean? Mandy Rice Davies became very well known in the UK after the Perfumo affair. Oh, did she? Yeah. I wonder if Miss Mandy Rice Davies could help me get closer to figuring out where Miss Marianne de Grimston was, and possibly another former Lady of the Night. If you guys catch my drift, maybe ivermectin will catch my drift the most. Hello, Mordecai. Happy Saturday, and I hope that you are doing well as well. All right, so let's look at this, and you guys got to tell me if this dude looks like someone. I can't explain it. That guy. I want to sit here and be like, doesn't he look like somebody? But I have nobody to compare him to. But that's Brother Nicholas, and I have no idea who he is, yeah? Now, I thought this was really interesting. So apparently the Process Church of the Final Judgment believes that the Book of Revelations condones suicide. So that's really lovely. And here I just underlined specifically the names of these other members within the church that I have not heard of before. And down here, they are trying to get involved in legislation up in Canada. So, you know, they're flexing their muscles really quick, yeah? And right here. They had a Roman Catholic nun that converted, which I think is interesting. Very interesting to me. They also adopted the dietary laws accepted by Orthodox Jews. And this is where they are switching over to the 12 luminaries. And specifically, Brother Amos and Sister Ayer both insisted that getting rid of negativity and thinking positive thoughts are a help to spiritual healing and to counteracting evil in the world. Okay, whatever you say. And down here, oh, let me zoom back in on this. There we go. So this is in Dade County specifically. Now, I just thought that this was really interesting. So Father Matthew estimated 100 people in Dade County have been fully active and that several thousands more have shown various degrees of participation. This was in 1974. I mean, 100 is a lot, you know what I mean, in my opinion. But as far as the Well, he said nationally. Oh, wow. His number's completely different than what they said in the court records. I just realized that. Because in the court records, it says internationally. He's saying just in the United States, it's 500,000. Well, that would make sense to me. Yeah? Makes sense to me if that's actually the number. Because maybe I'll tell you guys my little, like, PTK conspiracy theory about this. Let me see. There's a film about her. He looks like Paul Stanley, but it's not him, I'm sure. I don't disagree that he kind of looks like Paul Stanley. He just has like very striking features and I just can't put my finger on it. And I wish that I could. It's been driving me nuts since I saw the picture. What is the name of the film, Tawny C? I'm very curious. Let me see. People's misinterpretations of Revelations is one of the biggest problems right now. Yeah, well, you know, these people, they're just misinterpreting and reinterpreting everything. Bears a resemblance to Gabriel Galen Garcia. Ooh, Lisa Solis coming in with a name I haven't heard of. Thank you, girl. I will totally look that up. All right. Chris Sarandon from Fright Night. Huh. Maybe. I don't know. It's a possibility. Anything is possible, quite frankly. Now I'm thinking about Fright Night. I mean, that could be it. That could absolutely be it. Let me see what I want to show you guys next really quick. Because obviously these slides are going to take me some time to like really clean up. You know what I mean? But let's look at Reverend Teresa. Because I did find a lot more about her, which is nice. That way I can show you guys what she was doing when she was like running the circuit. You know what I mean? None. The Perfumo Affair. Yes. Scandal is a film about Perfumo. Bridget Fonda's in it. Interesting. Okay, I will totally check it out. Speaking of PTK, I'm reading Eye of the Chicken Hawk. Eye of the Chicken Hawk? I've never heard of that before. Is it PTK vibes? Because I'll read it. Eye of the Chicken Hawk. That sounds very interesting. I'm always looking for new books to read, specifically. Can you show the picture again? Yes, I absolutely can. Give me one second. Let me go back up to that slide. Yeah, because if somebody wants to try to figure out who this dude is, like I said, I will always take the help. Because there's just something about him, man. There's just something about his face that sticks out like a sore thumb to me. Okay, so hold on. Ready? Don't screw it. All right, there he is. Who is that dude? Who that guy? Who that is? Who that brother Nicholas? Who he is? Because, like, you know, they're talking about the stuff over here with Manson. They're talking about the libel case in the UK. Who is he? I want to know. I mean, he's a good-looking guy. I want to know who he is. Because I've never seen him before. He does not look like any of the other parties that I have found. But I need to know. Because you guys can tell, like, I obsess over these things, like, trying to figure out who these people are, right? Because it just keeps getting deeper. Now, let's look at the Rev. Teresa White. Yeah? Here we go. So here she is. You guys have already seen the one where she's warning the folks from Calgary, right? Like, the end of the world, yeah? It's coming. Da-da-da-da. But right here. And I found Stephen Hirono. I found him in newspapers. I found him with the foundation because I couldn't find him anywhere. I could not find him anywhere. I only had him in the process publications. You know, Father Lars, the advocate for, I think it's the advocate for Lucifer. Yeah, but I found him. There he is. So this is one of many of their quote-unquote Christian factions that they move out into. So the Christian Faith Renewal Center is one of their outreach ministries. And there is the evangelist Reverend Teresa White, Faith, Prayer in the Latter Days, sponsored by the Foundation Faith of God, a non-denominational Christian movement. Yeah? And over here, there they are again. Just talking about Jesus will return. They interpret the signs as an indication that the time is soon. Yeah? running around Saskatoon in Saskatchewan, yeah? Isn't that lovely? And then here's our gals that we have positively identified. Two ministers talk about the power of healing today. Now, I thought that this was really suspicious. Many Christian physicians refer patients to them for healing prayers. That's really weird. But then they say it here themselves. God is a universal God and a God of all religions. Yeah, so that's universalism. Not really into that. I'm not telling anybody what to believe. But, and then down here, they were working closely with Agape Women's Aglow Fellowship and the Full Gospel Businessmen's Fellowship International. Yeah, so now I've got to dig into all of that, which is really lovely, because anybody that they're working with, it's suspect. It's very, very suspect to me. Especially people that have money, people that have power. Those people are going to know who they are because someone's going to have given them a heads up. I just don't buy it. I don't buy it whatsoever. Let me go back up to the chat really quick. Jerry Dandridge is a vampire. I don't know who that is. Let me see. My brain went foggy. It's all about the network connecting Dean Corll and Gacy and a bunch of wealthy elitists. Oh, Mordecai. Well, maybe I'll tell you guys my my conspiracy theory about PTK. Gail Garcia. Okay, Liz. Elisa, I will totally check that out. Are you familiar with BitTorrent? I know like what it is, but I'm a noob, so I don't really understand how a lot of that stuff works. You know what I mean? Fire Pixie, I will go back and I will see what year that newspaper's from. I will find it and I'll like move the date and I'll put it in a separate photo because I'm trying to make a slide with all the parties that I don't have identified, but I'll add the date to that slide. That way everybody has it. I put Marmite in my coffee today, so I'm feeling sharp. Ew, that's disgusting. Let me see. Who was that Kardashian that basically got them going in the 70s? Huh. Well, the Kardashians were here like way earlier because the Kardashians were funding William Branham and The Message, right? Which that ties into like Jim Jones stuff. The Kardashian family was also funding like politicians that were involved with the KKK trying to get them in office all around the country. That's a fascinating story as far as William Branham goes, because eventually we're going to have to look at that, you know, because this is all like the revival circuit, the tent circuit. I mean, this is, you know, the time disparity is slightly different, but this is still the same thing, like straight up. It's the exact same thing. And that's why I said we have to figure out who all of these people are, because they are cloaking themselves. They are shapeshifters. The book of Revelation should have been left out of the Bible. The Council of Nicaea really screwed the pooch. Let me see. Teaspoon. Hold on. I missed a question. Oh, that's with the Kardashians. Holy S what? Holy S word what? The Kardashians are an STD. I don't disagree. Especially when I found out that they were like funding KKK. I was like, well, KKK politicians. I'm like, okay. What was the church you need to look into again? The name something something international. I don't know. It might be. I don't know. I have no idea. We'll come back to that. If you think of it or if I say it, tell me, because I don't know and I don't want to like completely brain fart. There's a good Program to Chill episode on Branham. Oh, is there really? That's fascinating because I have the book. I actually have both books. I have the one book that they wrote about William Branham and The Message, and then the previous book giving the backstory about the other, I can't think of his name. It's the other preacher that was there before him. You know what I mean? But he's running around doing the revival circuit because a lot of that stuff was going on at the Chicago World's Fair. That's all super sus too. And keep in mind, you know, I mean, they are in Chicago. You know what I mean? So I just think that it's all kind of interesting. The common denominator is alphabet agency involvement and Scientology. Lutfisk Climate, I would add that in, but specifically, yes, and Scientology. So to go back to that guy that we don't know who he is, was he in the process? Yes, he was in the process. He sure was Leash 23. That guy, I have no idea who he is, but he's in the process. And well, I appreciate you. Thank you so much. Because I don't know who he is, man, but he sticks out to me. JD Lotus, hello. I am so glad that you are here. All right, now, because I feel like I'm just going to brain fart on everybody. I want to show you guys specifically one former, thanks, Mr. Crow. I appreciate you. That's really nice. I want to show you guys a former Processian murdered her boyfriend. And I had only heard about this, and there was not a lot of specifics given in the one of the books, Apocalypse Culture by Adam Parfrey, where he interviews like some musician who said like, oh, I was in the process for a while and they helped me stop being a Nazi, whatever. They are Nazis, but let's go ahead and see what, we're not going to read this whole thing, but I want you guys to see it because I think it's important because she said some crazy stuff and she absolutely murdered her boyfriend. Here we go. So, okay. Lifetime of shifting between God and Satan climaxes with a hideous murder. So her name was Yvonne Kleinfelder. And it says in the 1970s, she began traveling New Orleans, New York, Florida, and Toronto. So she was part of the process. Need to figure out who she is. I haven't really dug into this much yet, but, and she was also part of the Foundation Faith of God. So she was an acolyte of the process, and she was also an acolyte in the Foundation. I'm just trying to read the parts that I underlined here specifically. There we go. But obviously, you know, Reverend Hope White, is that Teresa White? I don't know. But they say that they knew her in New York, and they are with the Foundation in New Orleans. Apparently, this lady's ex-boyfriend had shady ties to the mafia in 1975, and she tied him up and left him in a motel room. I think that that's interesting, obviously, because, you know, it's the mob. Yeah, because there's got to be mob stuff. But with her John Comer, her boyfriend, she stated that she was his caregiver and he basically became her mission at home. She was his counselor. And yeah, she murdered him. She murdered him. I thought it was interesting that she studied at the Moody Bible Institute. She told the cops that he wanted to be beaten. Sounds like something a Processian would say. And she was a high priestess of a double coven and devil worshiper. And according to her, because they asked why she didn't wear a cross, she said she couldn't. I still have three demons inside of me. Brother Bardas exorcised some, but there are still some left. And over here, which is a different angle I'm going to explore eventually, Evelyn Paglini of the Satanic Church said, believe me, I would know if a little chickie around here was ordained a satanic high priestess. Believe me, I would know. Whatever. But another angle that I am going to take eventually is specifically looking at where the satanic stuff is going on that I can find with the process stuff, you know, and then stepping back and looking at what's going on at the time, because I think that that's very interesting. Yeah. And then over here, Father Jason, I've never heard of him, but this was a music hall. And he was just passing out leaflets for the Foundation Faith of God. This is the first time that I have seen Brother Enoch be mentioned in anything else ever. This little TV ad, people are talking. They're talking about guardian angels. See how Timothy Wiley, when he did the guardian angels thing, it's not him. This is them. They're doing the same thing, man. They're doing the exact same thing. But finally, I see Brother Enoch on something, finally. And there we have Stephen Hirano again. How to live with love and how to live with faith. Yeah. And then over here, this is Saskatchewan in 1980. End of the world, said time of hope. And it's Teresa White and Sister Joanna St. John. So now I have to look that up because is it St. Joan or is it St. John? And they are talking about the latter days, right? Now this, because Mr. Francis Batista, he is a shady dude. So he was the director of the Foundation Faith of God in Phoenix in 1979, and he would not say how much money they were making. Does that sound familiar to anybody? Because remember, the lawsuit in the UK against Ed Sanders specifically, that judge said, like, hey, they haven't shown us anything. They haven't shown us how much money they lost. They're just in here saying that they're losing money. They haven't proven anything. And there they are doing the exact same thing. Like, don't worry about it. Yeah, is that why Best Friends Animal Society has, like, tens of millions of dollars now? Just a question. Nazis helping Nazis. That is right, Mordecai. Let me see. You nailed it. Church of Scientology. All the strange spring ups to be prepped for this time right now in history. Jesus, I'm staying single. Yeah, me too. Ivermectin. Hi, Samantha. No worries. No worries. Three demons. Hell of an excuse. Yeah, I don't think it's an excuse at all. Enoch Garrett. Three demons. Nothing a deep... Three demons. Nothing a deep auditing can't cure. Later days code for latter rain. Yeah, that's what I was wondering too, Jay Snyder, because this is majorly them in their Jesus phase, you know? And so I'm wondering, that's why I keep underlining it, because I'm like, are they really like, are they doing the latter rain stuff? Is that technically what they're doing? Because they're also doing like the psychic stuff. They're doing guardian angels. They're doing all types of crap, guys. They're doing everything. They're literally doing everything. They don't have a belief system. And that's why I don't believe the schism, as people call it, with Robert de Grimston, where they're like, oh, we split. BS. Excuse my language. I was going to say the word BS. They did. Maybe they pretended to split. But now, after seeing this over and over again, I think that the split was a complete joke. It was completely farcical. I think that Robert de Grimston was running a parallel operation, continuing with the satanic approach, because obviously there's still like satanic cults running around, right? But these people, they're still teaching the exact same thing. And what are they doing? They're getting in like the healing of the, you know, touching of healing, that laying of the hands, whatever the hell you want to call it. The same stuff that Jim Jones was doing, where people are coughing up tumors and saying that they're cured of cancer. Like, Jim Jones was using chicken organs for that. You know what I'm saying? But they're doing the same crap. They're doing the bio rings that are supposed to help, like, cleanse you. They're working with, like, numerology, psychics, you know, tarot reading. What else are they doing? The guardian angel stuff. And then that one lady's running over, you know, talking about birthing babies in water so they could talk to dolphins. You know what I mean? There was no split. That's what I'm saying. There's no split. It's a joke. It was a show. That's all it was. That was for public consumption. In my opinion, the split, the schism, the great schism of the process, Church of the Final Judgment. Yeah, that's for public consumption. And that's all that is, because they don't want people looking one way or another. Now, let me show you guys one of the most, you know, crystal clear things about the guardian angel stuff that I can show you guys. Listen. And learn about your guardian angel, yeah? So this is in 1981, and I mean, these dudes, they were hanging out with the Quakers, okay? The Ministry of the Angels of Christ is an outreach organization of the Foundation Faith of God. Over here, they've developed a religious instructional medium centering in angel listening, angel log, a correspondence run by the angels, and Angel Speak, the angelic newsletter. Through counseling called Angel Listening, a participant can learn all aspects of their guardian angel, the name and the language of the angels, the colors, the special gifts that angel brings to its mortal counterpart from God, and the personal message that the angel brings. And of course, because they have to address it, right? Quick to dispel myths that angel listening is fortune-telling, psychic reading, or spiritualism, ministers working with the ministry maintain that the information obtained through angel listening is a product of prayer through the name of Jesus Christ, and only through his presence in the individual can the communication occur. Yeah? And that's where I get to see Enoch Garrett again, which is fantastic. And then here's this gal. Gotta look into her, Estelle Lennon. She believes in angels, yeah? She becomes a rev super quick. Guardian angel, not mere myth, woman believes, huh? Isn't that fascinating? And there was a Canadian College of Natural Healing were the process was putting on a angel workshop, which is just really nuts to me. I'm sorry. Like, what a wild time the world used to have, huh? Now, over here. Let me make sure. Okay, so faith healing does have its believers, yeah? But they're talking about specifically all this. It's just literally relative. It's all relativism to me. They basically compare it to like a rock concert with Billy Graham vibes, which I think is appropriate. Now, this, very overdramatic, but what do we expect? So there was a bylaw to control drunks in downtown Toronto, I believe, but denied a request from, I'm just going to call them the process, from the process to solicit funds. And they said it's the kind of legislation used in Nazi Germany. That's a bit dramatic. That's a bit dramatic, especially considering that these people are Nazis. You know what I mean? I think that that is the lady doth protest too much, you know? Let me see. Ecumenical woo. Yes. I apologize if you've unpacked this before, but I'm new. No worries, Mordecai. Have you uncovered any connections between the process, best friends, and FLDS groups? Well, I've tied them to the Leavitts, at least to, or Leavitt. I'm sorry, I always say that wrong. Not David, but Michael. You know, Michael was helping them out. He was very supportive of Best Friends Animal Society specifically. I think that there is something to the arrival in Utah with that case specifically. Bishop Pace, like the statement from Bishop Pace, where they talk about the weird cult in the Wasatch Front, I think, where they're talking about like the satanic leaders within the FLDS. I think that it's legitimate. I think that that's very legitimate. I think that there's something to that. I have really, that's been my suspicion for a really long time. I don't think that the timeline is something to ignore. Now, I mean, I've tied Best Friends to Zion's Bank, which I know is owned by, you know, the Mormon Church. This is why, though, I have to figure out who all of these people are, because that's the only way that we're going to figure that part out, because that's where it ends, right? Yes, they've infiltrated facilities all over. However, like Utah, New Mexico, and Arizona, but primarily Utah and New Mexico, because, sorry, Zorro Ranch with Epstein, because I've been working on stuff about that too. Because there's some really weird stuff that's going on with the Church of Scientology that's been going on there. So, New Mexico, Utah, and Arizona. But primarily those two. That's why we have to figure out what they were running under. Who else were they recruiting? Because you guys are seeing, I'm starting to find new faces. You know what I mean? And so as I find new faces, then that's more people for us to look into. Like, I'm not upset that I was wrong about Sharon St. Joan. I don't want to incorrectly identify someone. And guess what? That just gives me a new person to look for. You know what I mean? Utah is a bizarre place. I would love to like see it in person. I really would, because it seems very beautiful, you know, but I know that there's a lot of weird stuff that goes on out there. Is there a difference between a polygraph and an e-meter? I wouldn't know specifically like the technical differences. I would say, I mean, polygraph's trash, right? And the e-meter literally just measures like the perspiration in your hands. And you're being interrogated. So, of course, you know, the little knob's gonna move. Like, it's junk. It's a piece of junk. It's a piece of junk that is used to manipulate people. Of course the thing's gonna bounce around if you're being interrogated. You think your palms are gonna get sweaty? Like, Eminem made a rap song about that. And he made millions of dollars off of it, talking about his sweaty palms. Seriously, it's stupid. I mean, I'm not hating on people. I'm just saying the idea that if you have left the Church of Scientology and you're still on board with the tech, right? And it's like, come on, man. Why? Mom spaghetti. Yeah, like, why are you still supporting that? It's just measuring the perspiration, Mom Spaghetti. You guys are so silly. I knew that somebody was going to say that. Using that phrase is a gross comparison on their part. Wouldn't a guardian angel work for God? Well, yeah, I don't think, like, when they said specifically that you would learn what the angel's name is in angel language, I was like, ooh, is it angel language or are they like putting a curse? You know, I know that sounds like very overdramatic, but I don't know. I don't trust these people. You know what I mean? I don't trust them at all. Now, let me see. I have more that I want to show you guys before we wrap up here, because obviously I don't want to keep you guys here forever. But there was one I knew I should have separated it. Dang it. All right. Well, I'll show you guys these other ones because, again, it's the end of the world, even though they're healing, right? Okay. Yeah, that's exactly what they're doing. No, they're not. Family law. Wonder if she does slack market adoptions. Just FYI, David Berkowitz adopted. Yeah. I haven't finished the book. I haven't finished the book yet. I haven't finished The Ultimate Evil. So I know that there's going to be like a whole other angle there when we get into it. But that's very interesting. I enjoy the book so far. I think that Maury Terry's kind of a jerk a bit, but I don't disagree with him. I don't care about the specifics of like ballistics and all of that crap. Like, I don't care. The stuff about the process, he is like on the money. I'm like, go, go, go. Like, he's on it. When it comes to the process, he's on it. I don't care what anybody says. That dude is right. Because I know who these people are. I know who they are. I haven't finished the book, but does he talk about them? Like, I mean, people don't have to answer, but I'm just saying specifically, you know, is it mentioned, you know, that they have, what was it? Like the healing ministry of the conquering king or whatever, like all these different healing ministries that they're able to run around and cloak themselves under. And they're using latter rain language, the latter days, the end days, you know, but they're saying that they're Christian, which is like, whatever, believe what you want to believe, but they're hiding themselves. They're cloaking themselves. Yeah, I think that he is a jerk. I think that he's a jerk. He seems really aggressive in the way that he writes. He also seems kind of pompous and does sound a little bit self-serving. I don't know how I would act at that time. You know, I don't have he didn't have access to stuff like this back then. So I don't want to judge him unfairly. And I certainly don't want to not give him credit. Thus far, I think he's done a good job. He's a bit of a dick, but he is 100% right about the process. And that's just how I feel about it, because I know who these people are. You know what I mean? So let's go ahead and take a look at the Healing Sisters, because they were the first Healing Sisters that we saw. Yeah. So here we go. So there they are. Sharon St. Joan, Hava Lawrence. They describe Jim Jones's group as basically communists. Such evil comes straight from the devil. Of the Moonies, Miss Lawrence says they're leading people away from Jesus instead of to him. I think it's super sus that they basically call Jim Jones a communist devil. That makes me think that they are absolutely working for the government. And here they are again talking about the latter days. Yeah, time is running out. Based in Phoenix. Healing ministry, evidence of the power of prayer. Yeah. And specifically, Father Hildebrand, a New York Episcopal priest, they healed him. Yeah. So they say. And they will do special meetings or in private. They used to wear uniforms, supposedly. And the headquarters in New York and in Phoenix. And I did highlight over here because I did find it interesting. You guys saw Sister Hava Lawrence, whatever she calls herself. She was married. You guys saw that photo of her in her wedding dress, but now she's not married because I guess she have to marry another minister. Yeah. And there they are setting up a prayer fellowship in Santa Fe. And they were very, very busy in Kansas as well. These two gals, oh yeah, very busy. And it says, by using the media, since December, we've reached well over 2 million people. This is from April 4th, 1979, so that's real wacky to me. And down here, Healing Hands, prayer power message of traveling ministry, yeah? So, the first sentence right here. The brown eyes of Gabrielle Lawrence and Sharon St. Jones sparkled with delicious expectation as they talked about the end of the world and their lifetimes. And there it is, the healing ministry of the conquering king. Yeah? The world as we know it is coming to an end. That's why I titled my my thumbnail that. But Christ is coming again. Yeah. And you know, it says that the healing ministry is an outreach program. And then they straight up start talking about necromancy. We haven't raised anyone from the dead yet, but we think it's possible. Okay, whatever you say. And then right here. This is another angle that I've got to really dig into. So the Spiritual Science Fellowship. So they were working with Reverend Marilyn. Now this lady, I'm going to see if I still have one of the articles pulled up. And I'll show you in the newspaper archives. Because this Marilyn chick, super sus. Like, super sus. But they were all together sort of doing these services. You know what I mean? And there is Raphael DePeyer. Yeah, that is Christopher DePeyer. What did he say? He said, healing is a central theme in foundation faith. He chose his new name carefully. Yeah, I bet he did. The word Raphael in Hebrew literally means God hath healed. And the Italian painter Raphael was also an architect. Yeah. And up here. Yeah. Father Raphael was christened Christopher DePeyer in the Roman Catholic Church, and Father John, who used to be Christopher, was an accountant, and he was Anglican. Oh, and look, I knew I had it in here. See, they were puking up tumors. Yeah? And there's the bio rings. It's a biofeedback device for healing. Now, made by America's foremost biofeedback research team. Who is it? Who was the foremost biofeedback research team? Who? Who is it? That's what I want to know. Because when was that from? That's from 1976. Yeah? I would like to know who that be. Who's the foremost biofeedback research team? Who's helping them? Yeah? Because they're straight up talking about necromancy and raising people from the dead. That's nuts. That's super nuts. As soon as they said that, they should have been investigated very seriously. Because, like, raising people from the dead, like, girls, y'all some straight up witches. Seriously, y'all. But do you guys see now why I say that they're hoes? That they are hoes. They're hoes, straight up. Let me see. Well, Leash, we're not going to talk about him, you know what I mean, because I don't need to be bothered anymore by disenchanted men today. Okay, let me see. Electroshock is streamlined by sleep researchers lately. It's with a head net giving small charges to extend alpha waves. Star Talk had the guy on the last episode. John Dee's writings are unreadable. That poor dog looks like he is begging for help. Yeah. Let me see. England was at war with Spain in his time and had to keep secrets. I mean, Jones said as much, but right-wing conservo Christian made them and assisted them. Yeah, exactly. It's just the whole, like, calling them a commie. You know what I mean? It's just that language. It's the whole just presenting it one way when I'm sure that they know damn well that that's not the truth. You know what I mean? Let me see. Paul of Tarsus said the same. Very interesting. It's sad how people fall for whoever when God is involved. Well, it's because they're playing on people's faith, you know, and for some people, their perception of eternity. That's why one of my conspiracies that, thank you so much, the World's Mayor Experience. I appreciate that very much. That's why one of my conspiracy theories is, that makes me so angry is if cults are all an intelligence operation, that's incredibly cruel. It's incredibly cruel because it is people's perception of faith, of reality, eternity, whatever you want to call it, if that's all just an intelligence operation, that's real nuts. And I think that that is a great reason to completely do away with the intelligence community, because the intelligence community is complete trash. But, you know, they get to take us on these war games and pillage and rape and pilfer and do whatever the hell they want. But this, if every single cult is an intelligence operation, because the Church of Scientology is for sure, you know what I mean? But if, like, seriously, come on. You think that people would maybe go out into the streets and do something? I would hope so. Seriously, I would hope so. Because, you know, this is people's livelihood. This is everything. You know, this is, it's a human trait to want to believe in something, you know, but this is just like manipulation on another level that I absolutely cannot stand. Now, let me see if there's anything else here that I want to show you, because I think, you know, right here, they're kind of just talking about the same stuff. Give me 1 second, guys. Yeah, you know, you guys have seen this one, you know, world near end, faith healers say. I showed you guys that one. And let me show you this interesting Manson article that I found about Marianne Faithful. Because some of this stuff I didn't know. And I found it really fascinating. Because obviously the stuff about Sharon Tate, the Cielo Drive, the LaBianca murders, that's always in the back of my mind. You know, I always have stuff sort of brewing that I'll randomly, you know, start looking at it. This newspaper article is very interesting to me, because some of the stuff I didn't know. I didn't know that Polanski had worked on another film. So, right here, In the Dark Shadow of Manson, 1994. So this is talking about Marianne Faithful, yeah? They processed members, and they're talking about Robert de Grimston, Robert Moore, whatever, how he was known as the Christ. Marianne was featured in the first issue of the church's magazine, lying naked on an altar. Her association with the church was ended at the insistence of Mick Jagger. One of Moore's philosophies was, thou shalt kill. Yeah. And obviously talking about the family, get the fear. And because I think that Kenneth Anger is somehow involved in this, specifically because of the stuff with Bobby Beausoleil, and Kenneth Anger was a Crowleyite, you know what I mean? I had to highlight this. Now, where is the stuff about the movie over here? Here it is, hold on. Ah, yeah, so right here, Eve of the Devil. I didn't know about that. And apparently Alex Saunders, British King of the Witches and heir of Crowley, initiated Sharon Stone into witchcraft during the making of the film. I didn't know that. And up here it talks about Keith Richard and Anita Pallenberg. Rumors of witchcraft involvement dogged Anita Pallenberg for years. So why do I find that interesting? Specifically because Timothy Wiley in Love, Sex, Fear, and Death talks about how Anita Pallenberg like rented him and I think Father Malachi a room for like a really long time. And obviously I'll iron out the details as best as I can and I'll show you guys, but I just thought that that was super bizarre because I've never heard of that movie before. So, you know, it is what it is. There's one more thing that I want to show you guys, and I'm trying to think of it before I completely forget and get mad at myself. So give me 2 seconds because I want to look at the chat, but I want to see if I can find it first. Where is it? I can't find it, then I'll just give up. But I'll tell you guys what it is, because it was a thing I found in the newspaper about best friends. And specifically, they talk about holding this event, and it's to get everybody together to talk about no kill, about saving the animals. But I'm telling you, this was a ritual. They just didn't notify the other people that it was a ritual, because specifically they held it on Halloween. I don't care if that sounds crazy. Like, I really don't care. This is the last thing I want to show you guys, because I think that this is really important as far as the language because you got to pay attention to what these people say. Yeah. Because remember, Hubbard said that he was just distancing himself, right? Even though they were declared SPs. I told you guys, I think that that's for public consumption. And I think that this here too, this is a little nod to the public. Yeah. That they are literally not splitting with Robert de Grimston. This is my opinion, that this is what this is saying to me, that this is a little, you know. Okay, so Jesus sect goes separate ways, yeah? So that is Brother Barnabas, which I know who he looks like in the documentary, Sympathy for the Devil. I've got to try to get some screenshots from that. But yeah, so this is their Lost Soul Patrol. Jesus people, yeah? This is the Jesus people. This is 1971, you guys. This is literally, what is that, July 1971. This is less than 2 years after what happened at Cielo Drive, that they're running down the Lost Soul Patrol. Yeah? This was immediate. They said they had it was highly emotional with bad spiritual vibrations, so they went separate ways. We're not against the process, people, one of the Jesus people told me recently. It's what they're doing. They worship Satan, and they can tear you apart spiritually. We don't dislike the Jesus people, a processian explained in a separate interview, but some of them are quite pushy. We choose to worship God in another way than thumping Bibles. Yeah? Tell me that the whole schism of the process is not for public consumption. Seriously, straight up. Because all that's telling me is like, hey, if you want to do the devil stuff, we're doing devil stuff over here, and we're still doing devil stuff too, but we got to do this whole like Jesus people LARPing, Jesus freak LARPing, you know what I mean? Let me see. Never thought about all cults being intelligence, and they have them in Asia too, worldwide. Yeah, exactly. They're global. It's a form of, in my opinion, behavior modification and group control. That's what cults are. And if it's an intelligence operation, well, you know, imagine what we could do with that money. You know what I mean? I auditioned to be the voice of the Scientology channel. I got to read the recruiting materials for their auditions. It is very believable, hence why I think people fall for it. The World's Mayor experience, hit me up. That would be great. That's very fascinating. I think that, you know, Scientology is... hats off to L. Ron Hubbard, you know what I mean? He has pulled off the most successful intelligence operation of all time, in my opinion. Jace, it was the British Israelites. Okay, you guys are having lots of good, deep conversations. The leader of the church or cult will have a leader who gets marching orders from those agencies. Yeah, for sure. Jesus said it was better that someone cast themselves than do that. Indeed. I started to notice a pattern among cults from California when I was looking into the death of River Phoenix, the Children of God cult reeks of CIA. Yeah, you know, it's really interesting, Lutfus Slimade, that you bring up the culture, the Children of God, because when I'm trying to find them and their whole, like, Jesus people movement, they're literally, like, with the Children of God. Which is fascinating because Heber Gentz specifically, you know, linked arm in arm with the Children of God when they went to court. Fighting for their religious rights. You know what I mean? I have that in a really old newspaper. So it's... I'm just wondering if this is where some of them all start to click up. You know what I mean? And obviously if I go down that rabbit hole, like, I'm never going to get anything done. So I need to continue focusing on identifying who these people are. I've obviously identified a few of their outreach ministries, right? And like the stuff with the guardian angels is just ridiculous to me, but hopefully that clarifies to people that Timothy Wiley didn't leave the process. He just didn't. He can say that he did all he wants, but he didn't, because they're talking about that super early. That's just what he, I think that he just gave that perception to people, because I'm pretty sure that he ended up dying, I think, in like New Mexico. I have his death certificate, like the dates and stuff and where it was somewhere, but he's where they are. He's where they are. This is all the same. seriously, why is Estelle Myers talking about, you know, babies talking to dolphins and that's why we got to have them in the water? And he's talking about, you know, talking to dolphins and doing drugs with John C. Lilly. He's talking about talking to guardian angels, you know, but they are too. And they're doing the same crap that Jim Jones was with the coughing up of tumors and stuff. Seriously. Let me see. Hold on. Fire Pixie. Leo Ryan. Yeah, the stuff with Leo Ryan is sort of complicated, but I mean, you know, what happened to him was completely wrong and tragic. Seriously. That whole story, because like Jim Jones was like my first, you know, that was the first foray into true crime, cults, whatever you want to call it. I was super young, and that's when I was like digging around on the internet, and I was like, huh? A bunch of people went where and drank what? Like, it blew my mind. It blew my mind. And now that I've gotten older and, you know, I've read so many books and listened to like every single true crime podcast, like last podcast on the left, like straight up, that's a limited hangout, guys. That is a major limited hangout, y'all. Straight up, because yeah, Jim Jones was absolutely CIA. Yeah, there were major intelligence ties to that entire thing. Last podcast on the left is a super limited hangout, in my opinion. Let me see. Why do these intelligence cults involve that type of abuse? Yeah, well, you know, I've said, in my opinion, it's about power. Money doesn't cut it after a while, right? You know, because you can be greedy, but once you have money, you know, literally money doesn't make you happy. People think that it does. But once that fix doesn't cut it, then it's about power. Yeah? And what is the most disgusting, powerful thing that you can do? Take away someone's innocence. That's the most wicked, cruel thing that you can do to somebody. Then you can also manipulate that person to basically be your puppet. You know what I mean? So they are kind of knocking out, you know, however you want to call it. And I don't want to refer to it as like a, you know, little misnomer or whatever. There's more than, you know, there's more than one way to skin a cat. That's all I'm going to say. I think that the people that do believe in these things, that are involved in these rituals, you know, some of them are well aware of what's going on as far as who their handlers are and the intelligence ties. So, you know, they are getting the benefits from both of that. Right? They know that their job is X, Y, and Z, and they also get to participate in the abuse, rape, murder, torture, kill, whatever, right? And then there's other people that are just there who believe, who are part of the rituals, right? And then there's the people that are just the intelligence assets. You know what I mean? True, I used to be rich and wanted to take my life daily. So weird how that works. Yeah, people, you know, people think that that kind of stuff is going to answer all of your problems. And I am of the opinion that that is not the case, because it's always a trade-off, right? Who is it? Gosh, he's a really famous author and he's still alive, and he's Thomas Sowell, right? He talks about how, like, it's a trade. It's always a trade. No matter what, you're trading something. You know what I mean? There's always a trade-off. It may sound easy, it may sound good, but at the end of the day, you were always trading something. It does not matter. Doesn't matter. Gotta give, gotta take. Yeah? And it is what it is, you know? But I'm gonna leave it at that for now, because I could sit here and ramble. Yes, Sowell is brilliant. Yeah, he is. I love his writings. He's just so smart. I love reading his work. I think that he's a very intelligent man. I'm ready to give no meatball. So I'm going to end on this note. I'm behind hole up. Just because I don't want to like change. Yeah, I love Thomas Sowell. I'm so glad that you guys know who he is. That's awesome. I love reading his work. And I enjoy like listening to him talk, like interviews with him. It's great. I really enjoy him. He's very intelligent. way ahead of his time, man, seriously, because nobody, you know, obviously no one's listened to him, you know what I mean? Not as a whole, but I don't want to act weird or anything, just because, like, I have, you know, some new people here, and I'm very grateful for the new people. I'm sick, and I don't know how sick I am, and I don't want anybody's pity. I don't want anybody's money. I'm just, that is an additional stress to the things that are going on with my home. And I am trying to avoid any drama. If that drama does decide to rear its head, then I will have to come on and I will have to address that. But I'm hoping that that is not the case. But again, I don't like the whole, like, pity, you know, that kind of stuff. Like, I don't want it. No, thank you. There are other people that could, you know, other people that need help more than me. It is what it is. Okay. But I will let you guys know when I do. And for the very few people that do know what's been going on, obviously, if you see things being said, you know, just let me know, okay? Because like I said, I don't want to do the drama, but I am also, you know, I'm not going to just, like, sit here and be quiet, you know what I mean? But I try to be as transparent as possible with my audience, and I don't want to stop that now. And that is also kind of why I was a bit scatterbrained yesterday and today. A lot of things have just come to a head. So if you are the praying type or whatever you believe in, I would really appreciate it. And we're just going to see where it goes from here, because I've had some people tell me that, you know, specifically some former processians are getting a little nervous. I don't think that these things are related. I've had some stuff going on for a while now, and, you know, I will find out if it has spread. That's what I'm waiting to find out, is if it is spreading throughout my body. But apparently some people are nervous. Good. Good. Be nervous. Because something happened. Something's wrong. And I'm not here for the clout. I'm not here for the grifting. I don't give, excuse my language, I don't give a fuck about how many views I get. I don't ask anybody for anything. And I'm not asking now. And I'm not. I don't want it. I don't like it. It feels gross. It feels gross and it feels wrong. But there's something wrong here, and I know that. And other people do too. And I am going, as long as I have the time, you know, like, the time on the planet, you know, I'm going to keep going. And then I've got my kill switch. I've got my fellow trusted researchers who I know will, you know, continue on with it. So it is what it is. Don't get it twisted that you think that this is going to stop me, because it's not. But I just wanted to kind of get ahead of some of this stuff, guys. You know what I mean? I don't want to change who I am because other people are being shitty towards me. I don't want to be like that. And I don't. It takes a lot of cruelty to be a kind person. And again, I don't want pity or sympathy, but I'm not gonna change and start acting a certain way. You know, I don't care. There could be five of you here, and I would be happy as I am now. And there could be, I mean, God, I wouldn't want like 500 people in my chat. I feel like that would be really overwhelming. But that's not what it's about. It's just about getting the truth out there, and it's about getting this up for posterity, guys. That's all I care about. And I, those of you that have been here, you guys know that. And that doesn't change. It doesn't change. That's the truth is what matters. Speaking up for the truth and for the things that have been hidden. That is what matters. That's all I care about, guys.